And welcome back to more God of Hell. Oh boy. I've learned a few things. Not the best of what I would have learned, but I've learned things nonetheless. I've learned that I now have two enemies on my hatred list because they're so fucking annoying. To the point where I almost had to actually re-bring in the clause about using the axe, like, legitimately.
I did it! You brought the main bridge back!
Actually, I shouldn't say you must find a way two, out. I should say one. Who the fuck was it? Anyway, if you heard about the tweet, it was something about dealing with, how was it?
Guess the light makes more than bridges. Maybe this will.
Oh yeah, the timed event. That one scene with the timed event. Jesus Christ, that timed event. If there's ever one thing I ever wanted to hate, it was that. And then, episode 14, honestly. I think it's episode 14. It might be further down, but I believe it's episode 14 because it makes a lot of sense what the hell happened there.
Look, the blue door.
And those assholes. Anywho,
you know, I will never get used to walking on solid light.
It was weird, like right now where I am at
the door.
Where I stopped right
what?
Now.
We have a problem.
Pretty sure I'm at least 2/3, maybe halfway there. Who knows?
These doors do not open.
Hello? I don't get it. I even have a door there. Hello?
Quiet boy.
Come. We will find another way in.
Yeah, we do. Plus, also, the fun thing is all of...
The dwarf again.
Sindri?
And that was all the side work.
This way.
I have
hey,
to
Sindri.
Do.
Hey, Sindri. Could you take a look at this?
Honestly? I don't have much else going on right now.
Here. Boy. Another one.
Done.
Hmm. She's a giant sorceress. Her name is Groa.
Groa Payables!
Looks like she had vision.
Sorry. Not the best thing to just yell out or anything.
Did Odin kill her for her book?
Shit. What the hell else was there, too?
I could use a distraction.
Oh, yeah, the lost items thing. I forgot about that. But anyway, going back. So, the reason why the Ancient Heart and the Ancient Rubble are all there is because when I, that was it. The beginning of this episode for 11 is on a different, recording session, so to speak. After 10, after dealing with, i.e. the fucking ancient asshole, and, you know, I didn't pick up any of the items, so when I reloaded the save, they were all just gone. Which means that everything I needed was to get off of, Sindri, and I think I may have missed, like, a bunch of shit. And, which doesn't really matter that much, depending on how you see it, because you can buy most things, I want to say. I don't know about, like, upgrades and whatnot, because the funny thing is, I have not fully upgraded the, Leviathan's Axe, because I didn't do Niflheim? Oh, shit. Oh, whatever the place is with all the smog, with like the deadly poisonous smog. I didn't do that. Mainly just because I was super frustrated with that thing. And I don't think there's a map. I take that back, there might be a map. That's my assumption. I'm like, I'd like think critically for like 3 seconds, like, maybe? Out of it. But anyway, yeah, because that's gonna be fun as all hell. Because in order for me to do the Valkyrie fights, I need to be jacked the fuck up. Problem is that I can't fully be jacked up because I have to save
more of those
Niflheim, and I have to also save what's the other fucking place? Muspelheim. Whatever the hell the fucking volcano hell of Muspelheim or whatever it is. Dealing with that, I have to, you know, do all that. So that technically leaves two areas to be because it just occurred to me too. I'm like, all right, so
hey Sindri, could you take a look at this?
Honestly, I don't know how much is going on right now.
Hey, fucking enemy. How did Sindri get ahead of us?
He and the blue one do seem to travel quickly.
We're inside.
This is a fun shitty part too. An interesting mechanic that happened to me. When we get to it, we'll get to it. Anyway, but going back to that whole shit about the two fucking special places, Lusophagen and Niflheim. Technically, I can actually, and before I actually, you know, rudely interrupt myself, I hated this. Like, that fucking root fucked me up good because the enemies go over it when they go flying. You can't jump over it, so. Yeah, it's fun. It's so stupid. Anyway, for the most part, going back to what I originally wanted to state, technically I could grind out those two areas without really confining to fighting the Valkyries. I know the one from Muspelheim is gonna be a bitch. Sorry, I had a warehouse. And I hated that. That was a shitty one. Because you have to use... You are effectively... at least in the news of Niflheim, at least in that one, so to speak, you're kind of neutering yourself, so to speak. I would assume, anyway. At least for that fight, because you need to have all of the resist. For some reason, my mind went to recovery for some weird ass reason. But yeah, that also is a fun hellhole of a fight. Because how the hell are you going to deal with so many of these enemies while playing, you know, beat the clock with these, you know, fuckboys? Trying to hell's hellhole anyway with those creeps. Because Lord knows it is going to be. So you have to get all those resistors, because Lord knows you need to do that. Also, how bent out of the shape of me not playing the game for a second, not using Atreus' arrows, like, at all. And that's fun. I mean, I don't know how bad it'll be in Niflheim, or Lusophagen, that goddamn volcano place. For the most part, mainly just because that crap is... Like, they're both, like, arenas, essentially. It's their bonus. It's the bonus decks. They're still ass because... Yeah, I can't just try and fix that. But for the most part... I remember beating the fire arena on normal, and that was actual hell. Like, it really was hell. Like, I can't think of what the hell the first part is going to be, because I can't think for the life of me how shit that match is going to be, especially for something like that. Because knowing that thing, just occurred to me too that I did not move these down to the muted section. This is, would really help if I did that for these things, because Lord knows I'm gonna need to. Because it's gonna be like really fucking weird in my ears anyway. And what's hilarious... Oh no, actually, I use that as buffers, that's right. I've been using that whole thing. It helps, because I don't have the whole keys down to actually being like, alright, how do I, take the, crop the audio out, so to speak, without having it affect the video. Well, kind of can, but that's a silly bit about that. But yeah, part of this fast forward as well is me stumbling trying to figure out a fucking puzzle, because that's what you just do. You stumble on those puzzles. They weren't as... Yeah, here it is. After I kill this dude is when I fucking, find the puzzle. And then be like, oh yeah, I gotta go from up here. Nope, we gotta go down there. that's how bad I was. I didn't think about it until, last second. But then there are all these fucking nightmares who just... who just go on suicide watch and just fucking end you. And it, shit, yeah, I was like, oh yeah, I could defeat these things, but Atreus' arrows just don't do enough damage, and even for 4, I would say, when you get all the way up there, don't do jack shit, so, yeah. So this part coming up, so I was like, alright, you know what, I'm gonna funnel these guys. See, yeah, this was like my, my brain thought, alright, I'm gonna gather all these guys up, so I'm gonna just fucking have them all the way over here, that way, so when I fight them, I'm gonna have, my eyes all set on them. Apparently, you could just skip it. Yeah, the nightmares didn't give a shit about you. You can skip the whole fight. And I'm like, what? So, yeah, that was just literally a thing. Forget for something, I don't remember. Will I find it? Probably not, because... will I find it in the second-ish playthrough? Probably. Mainly just because I'm going back to all these places, so yeah. Only just because, in order for this fucking, Valkyrie fight to work out right, you gotta fucking earn that right. But hilariously enough, a whole lot of...
They covered it up with that stuff. How'd they do that?
A lot of what's coming up in, these episodes, 11 plus, there are going to be so many fucking, fast forwards, multi-deaths and shit.
Do not assume. You are seeing the end of a war, boy. You do not know what led to this moment.
But he didn't even defend himself.
That was his choice. We make ours.
And then I was like, what the fuck are these symbols for anyway? And I'm like, probably nothing. I'm pretty sure that it is nothing. One of the things that also sucks about these fights against the Dark Elves are the fucking animals that can summon shit. Also, that move. I've learned to hate that move. And the only reason why I learned to hate that move is because... Well, I already spoiled the fucking fact that you get the Blades of Chaos, so why the fuck would I... If you remember the Horde fight that you have to do... Those... Because you're face off against Helheim's, forces and whatnot. When you watch, how I do most of this, because I'm going to... I'm not going to, burn it to 900 speed, because... The majority of the whole episode... I mean, I should anyway, because... Part of it mostly is all of just that one fight. Because that fight was hell. Legitimately, that fight was hell. I did learn one thing, though. I think this was, part of the fact that I had all of the shield upgrades, so doing all the things I have at my disposal, I learned a lot about how to handle, enemies like these. Because, you know what? You find out pretty quick that you can actually just chain strike motherfuckers. Pin him up against the wall, pin him up against a fucking, another, enemy, and just deal so much stun damage for practically just one move. You can hit him for, 3/4 of your fucking health. Or, for, 3/4 of your, fucking stun bar, and it's good. I may have made a mistake. No, I didn't. I have to remember too, like, I don't really, like, this is technically like my third viewing of this. Actually, no, second. Of the pieces itself, so. Yeah, then that happened. So, I'm, like, trying to articulate, like, all the death kit accounts and shit, so it's like, ugh. So I'm, like, trying to, like, keep an eye out for all that crap, but, I mean, after a while, you learn how to deal with that. Not by much, but, I mean, you deal with it. One of my... And the thing about the Alfheim fight here for this thing, too, is... I don't know... It's the dude with the twin headed staff. I don't know where the hell he is. I think he's in the red coloring. He's a summoner, and I hate him because you just eat like two of the regular dudes, and we're just sitting there like, fuck off.
What now?
The light is near. Look for a way inside.
I also love the fact that how much the fucking Adobe just lags like. It's hilarious, to be honest. But then again, this is like... It's outsourcing that whole... the fast-forward scene at like...
Follow me.
900% speed, so it's... It's going places.
Be ready!
Man, there was another, like, crazy-ass fight that I had, too, as well. One of the nice things about also Nightmare that you can deal with as well. I didn't think about something then, is making them kill their other enemies. Or making them kill their other enemies via their explosions. Because apparently they can do a lot of damage to other... to everyone else out there.
Okay, here we go! Nightmare!
But, like, trying to also get the timing down as to when they explode, where their radius is. It's
gonna be okay?
Very tough. Like, death. Because you can't parry it. You can't block it because it's fucking unblockable. Because you know Hong Kong magic. Okay. That one was just poor, like, all I had to do was block. Alas, I did not. Also, I love all the tips you get. You're just sitting there like, hey, I don't know.
Ready yourself, boy!
He ain't gonna do jack shit for you, guys, you know that. Even I know that. Especially with fucking... There's also, like, no way to, like, force a detonate from them either. That's what I hate more. And I mean, look how clean that was, getting rid of all five of them without taking damage. Then that happens, and they're just like, yeah, we can just do that. And then just... How the fuck do you get hit from that far? One. And then two, how the hell do you just deal with this shit? Like, nightmares were, like, the worst. Plus, another fun fact about that, too. The axe. Don't one-shot him. And I know this because... the Force Times part, which is the fucking. What the hell was it? Where the kid's chanting whatever the fuck it is in the sand bowl, and then it's just like, oh, well, we got this elevator here fucking with time, so let's just do this shit. Here's a timed event, motherfucker, have fun. I might be wrong on that. Only just because I'm like thinking, alright, how the hell did that fight go? Because I know, like, the third part. The third part was the worst because of how just, I'll state it in this way. The first part, all right, in the beginning of the third part, when you're at the third, when you're at like the third fucking, spawn set, let's go with that as a word. Because I can't say horde, because it really... I mean, technically, yeah, but, like, the way how, like, they respawn and whatnot and how it all goes down from there. It, I gotta fix that. Yeah, it's not three, that was six. I need a better edit, like all the fast forwards and whatnot, and put timer crawl.
You're restoring all the
timer crawls on that because I have markers everywhere. I actually might be three, but I don't know if that's like a slight wrong edit on my part or what. I mean, I can go easily just look it right back at it. Because I'm sitting here like, alright, there's three there's those there, yada yada yada. Because when I was fast forwarding the first part, that was three. And then... fast forwarding the other part, I believe, was... six, and then... no, I made the wrong shit. I mean, because there's four fast forward parts, so who knows. It's so hard to tell. I'm like not reading my own handwriting sort of deal, but I'm like trying to count. Alright, when the hell did I die in these parts? I am that stupid bit. Oh yeah. So here's another. So this is the beginning of like these weird horde parts you have to deal with.
I don't think we're supposed to be in here.
Quiet.
Forgot about this. Yeah, this one's shit spot. This is where you learn about the fucking horde shenanigans.
Did you hear that?
Stay alert and by my side.
Hey, when we make it to the light, how do you think we get it into the Bifrost?
The witch said to step into it.
She did?
When she was ripped away from this realm.
Oh, how'd I miss
that? Concerned.
You are more concerned with her safety than our goal. Quiet! I have him. Your knife boy.
Caught right in the fucking head. Technically, I don't know how soft those suckers...
That was close.
Where, like...
Do not stray from
the... where the hell, like...
You don't gotta tell me.
Because in all honesty, a skull is very hard to fucking hit, especially at the top, which is funny because, talk about getting,
another one.
Stay back.
When you talk about like getting fucking cracked in the head by a coconut, like, coconuts look like bad games. And it's like, but even where like the plate is, like so to speak, of where like the most...
Yes, we are near our goal, but we must be careful. Understand?
Oh.
God.
I guess where the thickness of the bone is, like, right there. Like, that is thick. But it's also hilarious, too, where it's like, yeah, this is also thick, too, but think about all the fucking concussions you get and all that shit. Like,
there,
damn.
When it falls, be ready. We will need to move quickly.
That's what sucks about drain damage, anyway. Shit like that. So seeing like Artrius just like easily just jam his knife into that fucking dark elf's head. Either they got really soft skulls or Artrius is really fucking strong. Technically the latter, but yeah, we know.
Stay behind me and protect our flank.
Yes, sir!
And yeah, I was trying to be cute about this whole thing, but nope. My ass. And they don't do much in the way of damage either, which is hilarious. They take chunks, but they take a lot out of you. But like, horde fights like this is when it sucks because of how much damage they can do. Because all of it adds up. You get 5 hits. Yeah, if you get 5 hits, then you're fucked. I think you can hear. I'm not too certain. I know. I think I was using the fucking regen burst, but I also think they drop.
When it falls, be ready. We will need to
move quickly. I don't remember the rules behind it. All I know is that luck is something or other. Runic is strong, but isn't what the kid uses.
Excuse you,
what you use is not what, like, the kids say bonuses of. I don't know if that's, like, true. Because I never really used Runic, I was always the heavy hitter. Mainly because I also never used the fucking axe, so. That should give you a good idea as to why I never actually used Runic attacks. I don't remember much about them. Funny enough, I was actually going back. I found, like, all of my old comments, and I remember, and I was reading about fucking Gerard and Jesse playing this game. Oh yeah, that's a weird number that just popped up. That was not supposed to be 209. Oh, I gotta go re-edit this thing again. Shit. Why'd that happen?
There. When it falls, be ready. We will need to move quickly.
That's weird. I get a lot of editing to do apparently with this episode, which means that I'm probably gonna have to, like, look at the shit.
Jump boy.
Which means I might have. I don't know. I don't think I might have to, just at least for this episode alone. I don't know, I'm hoping I don't have to start doing, like, double fucking save files where it's, like, before and after, because my editing skills are just, like, so fucking jank. Which is true. I ain't gonna deny that. Like, my editing skills are so fucking, like, square one just dig a tree. Like, I'm not gonna lie. He says over and over again. Yeah, like, meh. Editing skills are churlish.
Shorten the time between your volleys. There are many targets. You will not miss.
Had, like, just
a narrow path negates superior numbers. Stay focused.
I don't remember if I used it here. No, I don't. I mean, there were a couple of times where I used fucking the Spartan Rage power. Not by much, though, but, yeah. But, yeah, that fight was just, like, bleh. It's not the... Because you're, like, trying to figure out, alright, how do I go about this? Because the quick strikes are super fucking, like, obnoxious in this game. I didn't realize it till, like, afterwards. Especially when, like, fucking the, the house of the undead fucking frost soldiers start doing that shit to you, and then you realize, like, how good your timing has to be on, like, fucking getting that parry off, because it is hell. Like, legitimately, like, it is hell. At least for some of, you know, my fucking, like, reaction time, which is hilarious. Yeah. What I hated about most of those things, where it's just like, oh yeah, these fucking quick jabs are always, like, the most annoying of abilities. Also, doing that was stupid, for the most part. Because if I say that at the halfway point, where he was getting closer talking about, like, speed over accuracy, that would have been the perfect time to fucking do that. But alas, it was not. One more shit bit about that one was fucking, that wasn't, oh god, I can't think of it right now, bless, oh jeez, that'll probably pop up anyway, yeah, funny enough, I'm all confused, which I hate when I do that to myself. but also try to think too about the fucking, what the hell? Jeez. Oh, that's right. It was after the fucking boss fight. I'm like trying to think to myself, wait, didn't I have runic attacks? Because the kid doesn't qualify for the runic attacks. So I can use the fucking summons, because that's what they are. And it was a funny one that I actually, I don't think I ever grabbed in the main game. I think it was the deer. I don't think I had the fucking suicide deer. Like, I love the fact that, oh yeah, this deer just fucking blows up when he's like near shit. And it's like, I know the falcons, I know the one for the falcons is just utter trash, like, ugh. Because the Ravens one where fucking he yells out, broccoli, is the better one. But, yeah. Also, that slam. I gotta get back to doing this shit. I love this, though. Boy. Death in another world?
Are you injured?
Sure.
I'm fine.
It's...
Wow. It's beautiful.
And there are some times where I actually just don't fucking skip the cutscene. I don't know why, I just don't. I know I didn't do it for the fucking,
the light. It's making the whole
the Blades of Chaos one, because, like, that's super fucking important. Like, no matter what.
Wait. It's singing. I hear her! I told you I heard her! Do you think she's in there?
Ah! Ah! Dumbass.
That really hurt.
Yeah, when you're lying.
Like the angel's on fire.
I gotta go fucking back. More work. I don't like doing this.
Stay here.
But I want
to.
Oh, yeah, here, I'll give you my axe anyway. Last resort. Bet you ain't gonna be using it as a last resort.
We use it as a last resort.
In the next episode, we deal with some crazy ass shit.
I'm letting you.
I think it's the boss fight, but I'm not too sure. Anyway, remember to always stay alpha, always play your games on the hardest difficulty, and I will see you in the next episode of the God of War Psycho Challenge. Peace out.
You have to come back.